Hi everybody, I'm Stefan for cgtestplus.com, and in this tutorial I'm not going to show you how to make the video you saw in the preview for this tutorial, rather than explaining how to animate titles using effectors in Cinema 4D. So let's jump in and start. First of all, there are two ways to create text inside of Cinema 4D. The first way is to make a spline text. And for example, type your text, and this is a bit limited way, and you can animate only some of the properties of the text using the effectors. So let's change the font first of all to the official CGTuts font used in the logo. So this is our type, and we need to extrude it, so we are going to drop extrude NURBS and just give it a bit of depth and probably add some fillet caps to make it look a bit better. And the idea is that we are going to animate the titles, so let's come to the render settings and just change the aspect ratio to 16:9. And to do that, we are going to use, for example, a plane effector. And in order to link the plane effector to the text, we need to put this extrude NURBS object into a MoGraph object, so we can then link the plane effector to the MoGraph object. And to do this, we are going to use a fracture object. So let's create fracture object and make the extrude NURBS child of the fracture object. And by doing that, now we can see on the fracture object we have a TAPS effectors. So we can take and drop here our plane effector, and by default it offsets the position like so. Let's set this to 0. And right now we have a infinite fall off. So let's come to fall off and see the shape says infinite. So you can change the shape to whatever shape you want. In this case, I'm going to use a box shape. And here you can set the size of the shape. For example, let's set this to 600. And this to 250, for example, and probably set this to 200 as well. And let's move the effector like so. And right now, as you can see, nothing happens because we need to come to the parameter tab of the effector and start setting some numbers here in the position, rotation, or scale, and so on. But as you can see, when I increase the numbers here, it affects the full title, and probably we want the letters to fly in per character or something like that. So we need to come to the fracture object and come to the object, and the default mode is set to straight, and we are going to set this to export segments and connect. This way we can animate the letters, as you can see. For example, let's set this to -1050, and if we move the effector, you can see that the letters fly in one after another, which is the idea. Also, if you use the fracture object, I'm not sure you can see it, let's make a material and set the reflection to 50% and set the core to a darker red core, reddish core, for example, and put it on the text. And let's just create a plane and rotate it 90 degrees and move it here, change the size, probably make it like so, and let's set a luminance material to this just to show you that now we get these nice reflections. And if we set the fracture object to just exposed segments, the letters are kind of what is the same thing that if you take the text and drop it into a connect object. Basically it does the same. So let's set this back to export segments and connect, and basically that's the idea. And I'm going to, let's delete this plane. I'm going to show you how you can use and combine effectors to animate text. So for example, let's move right here and take our effector. You can, let's make a camera first of all, and reset it like so. So let's take our plane effector, come to the coordinates for the plane effector, and we are going to set a keyframe for the X. So set a keyframe for the X, move 40 frames forward and just move it to the side, and control click here to set another keyframe. So if we play our animation, it looks like so. It's very generic and basic animation. Let's take our camera and move it right here. And probably we can add some more life to this animation. Let's come to parameter tab of the plane effector. And let's see, click the rotation and start playing with the rotation. Probably we can rotate our letters and let's move like so. As you can see, we can set this to 90 degrees and probably rotate them like negative 45 degrees and a bit like so. And as you can see, our text animates, and it's very easy to set up this kind of animation. As you can see, and we can play with the scale, so the letters are, for example, bigger at the beginning. And then come to the normal size. As you can see, the letters are very big at the beginning, and as they fly in, they come to their original size. And that's one way to achieve this type of effect. You can combine effectors, adding more effectors, but this is a very limited way, in my opinion. The better way to do that is, let's create a new project and let's add a more text. Let's change it to CG.plus again. Let's change the type, let's change the font like so, and let's set the alignment to middle and add some fitted caps. Just like so, and give it a bit more depth. Let's create a camera and just reset it. Like so. And let's change the aspect ratio to 16:9 again. And as you can see, when we select our mode text, we have a lot of options. And here we have tabs like O, lines, words, letters. And as you can see, we can link effectors right here, so we can animate certain parts of the text. For example, we can animate the full text. So let's come to MoGraph effectors and again just add the plain effector, set the fall off to box and set the size of the box again like so, and come to the parameter tab, set this to 0, and for example again let's move it like so. And as you can see, our type by default flies in per letter. So this is very cool. Again, we can set a rotation and stuff like that. Also, let's come to the MoGraph effectors and add a random effector. And if we select our MoText, we can see that here on the letters we have the plain effector, but we can take and drop in the random effector. So as you can see, now our letters are randomized, and we can come to the random effector, come to the fall off, change the shape to box, and again just set it to bigger shape, set it to the fall off to box, and now we can link and animate this the same way as our plain effector. So we can affect our text as well. Another thing we can do is, let's just select our text and delete the effectors from the letters. For example, we are going to use only the random effector for this case. We can set this to random and affect only the letters, and come to the effector and set the random mode to noise, for example. And we need to move, let's set the fall off to infinite. And if we play it, we can see that it affects all the letters. And just wiggle them around randomly. We can come to the effector and we can add some rotation, probably. And if we play that, you can see that it starts to look kind of a comedy fun title which moves around, and we can change the animation speed right here, probably set this to 50%, just like so. You can set the scale to 200 so it's smoother, or set this to 25 so it's a bit faster, and you can just set this to 10% so it kind of slowly the letters fall in the space, and you can animate cameras and make some dramatic title sequences. But come to the text and let's come to the letters and delete the random effector, and let's type cgtuts plus presents and come to lines and put the random effector. As you can see, it now affects the full line or the text. If we delete that, just stop it and delete it, we can come to words and just drop it here, and as you can see, let's increase the speed of animation so we can see better. As you can see, it affects each word separately, and we can't achieve this result using the spline text in the fracture object. That's a option only for the mob text, so this is very cool, and this works for every MoGraph effector. So you can delete that and set this to all, for example, and again it will affect all. The same as if we drop it to the lines tab, basically we get the same result. But I think the most interesting thing is to drop it per letter, and probably you can use something like this and drop the plane effector as well. And we need to increase, this is default off, the red box inside is default off. So as you can see, it smoothly reveals the text, and we need to increase the size. So let's set this to double the size and just zoom the camera in and come to the coordinates for the plane effector. Come to the beginning of our timeline, set a keyframe for the X and move 50 frames forward. Just animate it in. And probably let's delete this. And as you can see, we have some nice random animation. We can come to the random effector and reduce the speed of the animation. You can texture that and make some nice titles. Of course, this is too slow for this case. And you can do a bunch of interesting animations. I'm just going to show you one type of animation which is kind of cool. So let's create a new composition and drop a Mograph text, and let's type again cg.spus and just set our font, give it a bit depth, probably a few subdivisions, set some fillet caps as well, and let's constrain it. Let's drop a new camera and let's set it further from the text like so, and Control B for the render settings and set the aspect ratio to 16:9. And let's drop a plane effector again and let's drop it to letters, the plane effector, and set the parameter to 0 for the Y. And we are going to play only with the rotation for this type of animation, so let's set this to box and move it just like so, increase the size like 900, 250 and 200 for our text, and come to the parameter tab, and we are going to play with the rotation. So we are going to rotate our letters 90 degrees like so, and also animate them negative 90 degrees like so. And we are going to take our effector and set a keyframe here, move 60 frames forward and move it like so, set another keyframe, and as you can see we get this nice rotation of the letters. We can speed it up just a bit. And the cool part of this is you can render a single sequence like so, and then you can start your next title from this point. So we are going just to invert the keyframes. We can set this here and this right here. You can start and just type something else like cg.spus presents, and as you can see we need to just animate it. So let's set a keyframe here, and instead of moving backwards we are going to move forward like so, and you can dissolve nice your titles using this technique. As well as you can create some interesting effects combining the random effector in the position of the plane effector and stuff like that. Basically, you can create infinite combinations using effectors to create your creative title sequences. So that's the basic idea. Hope this tutorial was interesting for you. And let's see if we drop our plane effector twice, you can rotate your titles, but this doesn't look so interesting. So the best option for me is using the letters tab, but it depends of what you're creating. So that's it for this tutorial. Hope it was interesting and useful and give you a basic idea on how you can animate your titles and create amazing title sequences using the effectors and the different options for creating text in Cinema 4D. So once again, I'm Stefan for cgtutsplus.com, and we'll see you next time.